Welcome to Africa's Entrepreneurs. I'm Alicia Sekhem. Now, tonight we're focusing on risk-taking and particularly the relationship between venture capital companies and entrepreneurs. Who takes on more risk and what kinds of risks are there in these kinds of transactions? Well, joining me in studio is JP Faree. He's Executive Officer of the South African Venture Capital Association. And in Cape Town, we're joined by Tony Malam, partner at Cape Venture Partners. Thank you both for joining me this evening. And JP, let's start off on your end with some perspective on the current venture capital industry in Africa for 2008. I mean, what kind of mood or activity are we currently seeing play out in this arena?
Sure, there's been a lot of activity, Alicia. To start with the South African context, if you compare this time of year to last year, there's definitely less private equity type of activity on the bigger end of the market. So we're not seeing as many large transactions. We have seen a lot of venture capital fundraising taking place in this part of the year. A number of funds have closed large amounts of capital available for venture capital investment. In Africa, definitely a lot of activity. A lot of that activity is expansion and development stage businesses that they're financing. Which is a little bit different to the South African market, which is probably a little bit more developed in terms of big buyout transactions or private equity transactions taking place. So a lot of activity in the venture capital space, both in South Africa and in the rest of Africa.
Private equity, though, has come under searing public scrutiny, both in Europe and North America. Does the same hold true in Africa, more specifically with regards to the investment philosophy of venture capital?
In terms of the investment philosophy, definitely not. Venture capital investment, unlike private equity, involves a lot of active participation by the venture capital fund manager in growing that business that they're investing in. Where in most instances in a private equity type of transaction, the management of the venture or the private equity fund are a little bit more hands-off. So there's a lot of emphasis on development of businesses and hence investment into developing type of businesses. To give you a context for that, of the investments made in the South African market over the last 9 years, some 44% of those are investments into businesses that are in the expansion and development stage, both by number and by cost, which far outweigh some of the big profile transactions that hit the media in the US, Europe, and in South Africa and other parts of Africa.
Tony, how recognized is venture capital funding as a finance vehicle in South Africa and on the continent at large? I mean, what are some of the current perceptions of venture capital funding?
I think one of the current perceptions in South Africa mainly is that venture capital is fairly difficult to come by entrepreneurs. I think there's a missing level of the angel investor type scenario for startups and seed businesses. And entrepreneurs who are looking for venture capital funding are finding it difficult to access that funding. I think the bulk of the market is, as JP mentioned, in expansion capital and later stage activity. And we've seen two new funds, or one being HBD's second fund and the other one being the Hasso Plattner Fund, come onto market recently, who hopefully will change that scenario and make it easier for the entrepreneurs to access venture capital funding.
And also just the understanding of what venture capitalists are all about, really emphasizing this point that you're making. And if we are to use an example, it's often overlooked as a vehicle for achieving broad-based black economic empowerment as well. So if you could you explain how it would work to develop BEE, for example?
I think in the case of venture capital funding, there's more of an emphasis on broad-based entrepreneurial development as opposed to broad-based black economic empowerment. But it certainly has a role to play in bringing through your young entrepreneurs and bringing them into the marketplace and giving them the access to the funding. And then rolling further into the chain at the private equity level, I think venture capital has a huge role to play in black economic empowerment.
Now, JP, according to a KPMG and SAFCA Venture Capital and Private Equity Survey for 2008, the forecast was for minor speed bumps ahead. Have those been hit yet?
They're not as steep or as big as speed bumps as we had predicted. Yes, for on the private equity side, debt markets have become a lot more tighter in terms of credit crunch and inflationary pressures and the likes. But definitely on the venture capital side, Tony mentioned a couple of funds that have been raised already. There are a few more in the pipeline, all looking to invest into smart technology, IP-rich type of businesses. And that's where I think we need to begin to draw a distinction from private equity vis-a-vis venture capital and SME development, where venture capital really focuses on investing into technology-rich or innovation-rich businesses that have got a global type of application. So they make big-time returns because they're taking on a lot of risk when that business and the business model is successful and applicable into broader markets than just South Africa or Africa.
Tony, if we take a look at the broader operating environment here, I mean, we are faced with a credit crisis, higher inflationary environment, and thus higher interest rates at play as well. We've got the threat of a serious economic downturn on the horizon. How has this impacted your business specifically, if at all?
Well, funnily enough, we were having this discussion the other night. In fact, it's been quite the opposite. We're seeing a huge amount of entrepreneurial activity. We're seeing some fantastic innovation. We're seeing some good stuff coming through our pipeline. And in fact, we've never been busier. So I don't think from an entrepreneurial point of view that the sort of the economic factors of the higher interest rates and inflation are actually impacting. In fact, they're probably contributing more to people getting out there and being more innovative and looking for new solutions. And we're certainly seeing, as JP mentioned, scalable and globally appropriate technology coming through. It really is going to put South Africa and Africa on the map.
JP, do you find then that in this context there's an increase in global venture capitalist investors coming in and targeting Africa specifically?
Definitely. There's been a lot of interest. It's something that, as the association, we track in order to understand what is that investment appetite for South Africa, for South African private equity and for South African venture capital. Some of the funds that have been raised are funds originally sourced from Europe and the USA, so they've invested into South African fund managers to manage a venture capital fund. So there definitely is a lot of interest, and South Africa and Africa to a large extent is kind of seen as the last frontier. And at the same time, the credit crunch in more developed markets has meant that private equity and venture capital fund managers look to other jurisdictions to make investments to deliver 25% type of returns, which are becoming more and more difficult to do in some of the developed markets, which puts South Africa on a very good footing. And I concur with Tony's views. We need to capitalize on that in terms of coming to the fore with smart technology and the likes.
In that respect, though, Tony, I mean, what position does this leave a company like yours in?
It actually puts us in a very good position because we're just seeing so much activity in the technology environment particularly that is relevant not only to South Africa and Africa, but we're seeing it applying more and more to other developing economies such as India, such as China, such as Brazil. A lot of South African technology is already making an impact. The Mixit guys, you're going to be chatting to Ian Harrison just now. SciTech is making a big impact in other markets other than our own. So it's exciting. It's really good at the moment.
What are some of the fundamental issues necessary for really developing and maintaining sustained growth levels for venture capital companies?
I think it has to be deal flow. Deal flow is quite important in terms of making sure that there is sufficient scalable and expandable innovation to satisfy the venture capital appetite. As JP mentioned, we're seeing more funds being raised and we've got a lot more interest from offshore. But it's going to have to be sustained by good deal flow, which is where someone like ourselves plays a role in nurturing that deal flow through to the bigger companies. But the other thing has to be the regulatory environment. There has to be encouragement from the government side to get people more interested in investing in this private field, if I can put it that way. It's a different asset class. I mean, so those are the two important aspects.